YouTube. Today at Power Jack repair. We got a Lenovo IdeaPad 315II L05. Maybe it could be 1511L05, but also it's 81WE. Let's see if the camera can zoom in what I'm saying right here. IdeaPad 3. All right. And the problem is the power jack right here is damaged. Let me show you the damage. And what we're gonna show you is how to replace that jack. And for that I need to take everything apart. Send this aside. And the reason we show you that, if you want, you could send us the whole laptop. Or if you want, you could send us just the motherboard, it's gonna be slightly cheaper. All the information is right here. Right there. Above. All right, at the powerjackrepair.org. So let's begin taking it apart. By the way, we also sell the parts here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 screws. This laptop needs 20 volts 3.25 amps. That's in case you need to buy another new charger. All right, so let's see. All right, this is also Core i3 10th generation. Wow, it's relatively new laptop, Lenovo IdeaPad 3. Well, let's see. I'm not sure if we even had this laptop before. I like the screen being matte. I like that the keyboard and the top cover is the same thing. So here what we're gonna do is we're gonna go right there and kind of get everything separated like that. All right, so let's put everything down and easy, you see. Okay. So here we got the jack right there, and usually what happens, the back of the jack at the pin, I'm not going to touch it yet because the battery is connected. Let's disconnect the battery so that those are the electrostatic gloves, so I could touch anything I want here and nothing going to get shorted. But here, let's disconnect the battery. By the way, if you can't see something here, it would be a bright idea to use a big screen like a LED TV, 50-inch or 40-inch TV, to see everything that I'm doing here. And thanks to your donations, we are investing everything into higher quality productions. So again, if the video was useful, will be useful, just consider leaving a like. All right. Yeah, I know it takes a bit time, but I don't want to break the port for the battery here. All right, I probably need to remove the battery because I will need to insert this guy in and that guy in safely. So let's remove the battery. And the way we remove the battery is one screw right here, one screw right there. Right, three screws, we remove the battery. The battery is kind of small for some reason. I was thinking it should have much bigger battery. All right, let's see if we can zoom in a bit closer. That's a little bit too much, but anyways, that's the closest zoom we got. Here we just raise it like that. You know what, I should probably use a slightly different zooming option. Let's do this option right here. You can see everything like that. The other one was over too much. Basically here, we're gonna unplug this guy. Here we got the two screws right here. Not the screws, two wires for the antennas. One is main, another one auxiliary. And we want to unscrew that screw for the wireless card. All right. And we're going to remove the wireless card. And we got the solid state drive right here. All right, make sure to remove it together with the pad, because this is a cooling pad. It keeps the card nice and cool. All right, I want to set it aside right there. Here we have the fan cable. You want to unplug it like that. And we got one screw, two and three for the fan. All right, so we got three screws for the fan. Let's see if the fan is, we're just gonna set it aside like that. We don't need to remove it because we had to re-guide the wires in there. Those wires we had to re-guide. One cable right there. It's a proper hinge, so just unplug it like that. Unplug it like that. And here we got the LED cable right here. Plug it like that and remove it, but moving it a little bit higher upwards. And I honestly don't like the way how it's guided here, but you know, I would rather not touch it. For some reason, one screw is missing right there. For some reason, no reason whatsoever. It's probably bouncing around here someplace, probably. No, nope. I turned it over, I didn't find anything. Now we got one screw right here, one screw right there. One, two, and three right here. All right, so those are the three screws for the motherboard. Could be screws under the memory chip. Could be not, but that seems like that's all I got here. All right, and we also have, all right, so we also got this CMOS battery, which we want to unplug. All right, let's see. Come on. Yeah, okay, don't break the connector right here. Okay, so that's how you can take it all apart, and you could send us just the motherboard. It's gonna be much cheaper for us to work on it. So for you to, you're gonna save some money. Now the problem here, you probably won't understand what the problem is until I take this guy off. Usually that pin in the back right here gets cracked. And this rear pin is the positive pin, and right where it meets the pin, it gets cracked in the back. Now you're not gonna see it until we're gonna take this whole part, until we take it all apart. I meant to say until we take it off the motherboard. So let's see. What I'm trying to do, I have this Captain tape right here. This Captain tape, I just need to find an edge where it starts at and which way it goes. That's the equation, all right? So it probably goes this way. All right. Those are not the best gloves for the Captain tape, but here, let's... All right, like that. I'm insulating the motherboard right here. Let's do a much wider angle. I'm insulating the motherboard around the jack because I don't want the nearby components to fly off the motherboard. This one especially, this is kind of a pain to solder it back. Oh, by the way, take a look right there. Take a look. It seems like there was not enough solder on the points to begin with. You see that the holes are empty. This hole is empty, that hole is empty, this hole is empty, that's empty, and that's empty. And take a look right here. Half of those guys are empty, so I guess this is what Lenovo, you know, IdeaPad is saving money on soldering now. Now they're not the only ones, trust me, there are a whole bunch of other. Well, what's that right here? Looks strange. Anyways, what I'm trying to insulate here is the capacitor behind, as well as the LED, as well as the LED lights right here on the front. And we're just gonna guide it like that. And let's insulate this guy as much as we can, because I bet you that it's gonna start moving as soon as I'm gonna add some hot air to this. I will zoom out in a second. I just want you to see a bigger picture of what is it I'm doing here. All right, so like that. Come on, it's hard to insulate a component on the... this is gonna, it's not gonna hold. There is really nothing I can do about this component. It's probably gonna fly off right after I start. There's nothing to put the tape to here. Okay. So let's leave it like that and be extremely careful about... Here, let me show you. Here on this side. Different field of view. You see this component right here? It, after too much heat, it can be flying off the motherboard. That's a digital zoom, so I apologize for such a huge quality loss, but this is not digital zoom. All right, so the way how we're gonna take this guy out of here is by adding some flux here, 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 and on the other side as well. Right here. Here, 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 and there. All right? So here, 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 here. And then we're gonna add some leaded base solder to the points. Leaded base solder gonna mix with the unleaded base solder. And that way, the melting temperature gonna fall. And we would be able to use hot air station just to drop this guy out of the location. But my concern is this piece right here, which... On the other side, that piece on the other side, there's nothing on this side. So let's switch to the soldering station. All right, my friends. Here I'm adding some flux to the bottom of the jack. Here I'm adding some flux to the top side. All right. And a good idea would be probably to start from the top as well. That's a brand new jack right here. We're gonna set that guy aside. And let's see what we can do here. I'm just adding some solder here. I'm adding some solder right there. Some solder right there. And right there. And to the top right here. All right. Now I flip it over. And I'm adding the solder to those joints right there. We remove the excess. For some reason, there is a hot glue on this wire here. So we're removing that. We're removing, adding more solder right there. Let's add a little bit more solder here. I know it goes counterintuitive to what you were thinking. You're probably thinking that that the best thing to do is to remove this other, but trust me, I know what I'm doing here. I'm gonna position the hot air a little bit above the points. And let's start with just a little bit of heat. And we're gonna heat up this portion and that portion with the hot air. Let's help with the soldering iron. Again, that's so that the leaded base solder would mix with the unleaded base solder. All right, so the leaded is the one I'm adding. It has a much lower melting temperature than the unleaded base solder, the one that I am. All right, so we need to see if this is all right. Okay, so we already have some progress on that side. Let's see if we have progress on this side as well. Come on. Lift up the board. Come on. Alrighty. You see, everything lifts up just by warming up this connection here, you see? Alright. Because it's one big heatsink, this guy. Alright. Now, once we removed it, we set the heat source soldering joints. We bring out the soldering rig, and we are desoldering everything right here, like that. We're gonna desolder everything right there as well. Alrighty. Alrighty. Oh, you see? That's what I was afraid. The component went off the motherboard. Right there, you see? Okay, so that was the thing I was worried about. Now we need to solder that component back to the motherboard. This one. And that's gonna take me quite some time to do so properly. So before I'm gonna do that, I need to finish up the soldering of the desoldering of the points here. All right. All right. Alrighty. Let's solder the missing piece back to the motherboard. Okay, we don't have anything else missing. I knew right away that piece is gonna fall off. I mean, there is no way to desolder the jack properly without losing that piece. All right, shut down the hot air. Alrighty, so here we got the three. Hold on. Here we got the three soldering points. One right there, one right here, and one right there. Alright. All right, now let's try and solder this guy. That seems like excess solder, which I need to remove. All right. Let me get my precise tweezers. Guide this guy in place. All right, so let's solder the two side legs. All right, so it's soldered on that side. Let's solder the other side. I don't really have a nice access to the other side, so let's solder this guy right here. All right, looks good. All right, let's touch up the other side. Alrighty, okay. And then after the cleanup, it's gonna be just beautiful. Again, I was 100% sure that this thing not gonna work like that. Alrighty, so what I'm gonna do now is add some flux right here, right here, right there. And put the new piece in place like that. Keep it slightly above. And let's try and add some solder to the equation. Meanwhile, you want to hold it down. Okay. Right, and we got some flux on the other side. Alrighty, let's remove the excess solder that we got right here. And right there. Alrighty, looks good to me. Now let's tune up the... And let's clean this thing up. Alrighty. And after the cleanup, I will let it dry a little bit. All right. The reason I want to clean up because you don't want anything to corrode here over time. All right. Wonderful. Beautiful job. Really beautiful. I like it. All right. Let's clean up the pad, because this pad, I don't want anything to be stuck to it. And then at the end of the day, I usually clean the pad. All right, but it's not really interesting for you. Anyways. Alrighty, let me show you the beautiful job I did. Right there. Right there. So it's soldered from both points, from up and down, from upper side and the lower side. And I just wanted to test the here, that's the ground, that's the plus, and there is no shortage, meaning it's all good. This is minus, 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 plus. All right, all good. Let's try to put it in without damaging anything else here. All right, so like that. Like that. Okay, wonderful. Let's connect this wire right here. Okay, all right. Let's connect this wire right here. Make sure the white line is being covered by the connector. We are putting this fan right there. And I wonder which way is up. Up is probably like that. Okay. Let's connect the LEDs cable. Now you have to be extremely careful on that cable right here, because I'm sure, since the laptop is relatively new, there is no new cables like that available, let alone used ones anywhere in the United States yet. Here we are connecting the keyboard. Again, if the video was useful, please consider leaving a like, subscribe, so I would let you know which laptop makes and models I would buy for myself, and which ones I would never even use, even if they are free. All right, so close down this hinge right here, and this one doesn't have a wire, and that one doesn't have a wire. Probably one of them is for the hard drive. Okay, so let's connect the wireless card first, right there. Like that, Let me find my favorite screwdriver. Again, not sure if it's if I already mentioned it. It's better if you watch it on a big screen TV. Alright, so white wire gonna go right here where auxiliary. Alright. And the black one gonna go right here where the black label is at. Okay, right there. Wonderful. Now, don't lose the special screw for the hold on 1 second. That special screw is Lenovo. Unbelievable. Here. That's really special screw. All right, so we are gonna put this guy like that. Bring him down like that, push it in. All right, seems solid enough. Oh, hold on. Where did that screw came from? Right there. That's the missing screw from here, I guess. Yeah. I just found the missing screw, guys. Do I have to take everything apart now? Hold on, let's... I knew there should be a screw here someplace. But it turned out it went... this way. All right, come on. Come on. Yep, come out like that. Good job. You know what? I'm thinking that this screw is what probably shorted something on the motherboard. Come on, you don't go in there. All right, here. It probably shorted something on the motherboard for sure. Because I want to inspect the old... the old jack, and I'm pretty sure I'm not gonna find anything wrong with the old jack. Alright, so this one goes in here. That one goes right there. And... now, the only reason this laptop wouldn't work is probably because the board is shorted because of the screw. Let me find that old jack. All right, so you see that the rear pin is intact. It's still in here. Now, I was wrong. Now, the jack was bad right here, you see? There is something stuck in there in the barrel. So basically the plug itself broke inside of the barrel and there is no way to get the plug out. So you have to replace the whole jack. All right. Okay, garbage dead connector. Well, I have the gloves on. I put some tape right here so that in case the screws come out in the future, they would not go too far away. Alrighty, so we got several screws here that you need to mount. And alright, let's see if we know where each one is going. So probably the one right here. Nope. I guess one right here. All right, another one right here. Right there. Let me see where. Okay, so there is no screws here. Meaning, do I put a screw there or not? That's the question I have. I don't see any leftover screws. You know what? That screw was probably from here. I want to make sure that there is no other screws left anywhere here. I'm just shaking everything out of the casing. All right, so here. That aside, remove that, set that aside. Alright. So the three screws probably gonna go right here. Okay, does it go under or does it go on top? That's the question. Okay. Let's connect the battery first. All the way in. Now we just wanna drop everything down right here. Okay. Okay. I'm not 100% sure that this is the proper length for the screw for this application. That's my problem. Let me put this long screw right here because I'm thinking that this is where this screw belongs to, right there. All right, and when it comes to those guys, I don't want to penetrate the connection further in. No, that looks fine. Okay, and one screw right here which I don't have anywhere. Oh, found it. Okay. Found the last screw missing. Okay, so here. That's the screw going in right here. Right here. Okay, looks good. So cable here connected. Two cables right there. What I wanted to do, I wanted to put some tape on top. Right there. All right, and let's close everything down. All right, seems like everything's connected. One here and that cable there. I mean, I don't see those cables anywhere. Right there is one. Okay, I just want to see if this laptop gonna power up and work. Okay. Overall, really easy laptop to work on. If you're local, stop by, the repair should take about an hour. Alrighty. Here. We'll mail it in. Short screws go on the front. Alrighty. And the rest of the screws go all over the perimeter. Okay. Wonderful. One right there, and one right there. Let's drop this one right here. Good job. All right, the client provided us with the brand new power supply. Stylish design, E support, so they can fix your jack E support right there. Good. Thank you, Lenovo. Thank you, Lenovo, for keeping this business alive. If it wouldn't be for you, Lenovo, thank you. Anyways, so we got a brand new power supply. I'm not sure if this power supply is compatible with this laptop overall. Let's see. Oh, wow. Compatible. You got something blinking here. You got something blinking right there. And nothing comes up right there. So blinking here and blinking there. I'm not sure what that means. And we want to try and power it up, or it blinks because it says the battery is dead or something here. Let's do. Probably blinks because the screw shorted the motherboard someplace. All right, it just keeps blinking. Oh no, it does power up. Wow. Lenovo right there. Please leave a like, subscribe. I will let you know which laptops I would never buy. And which laptops I would spend my money on. Anyways, maybe this was a, I mean, 10th generation i3, that wasn't cheap for sure. And it just came out like half a year ago. Restart my PC, so the touchpad works. Okay, that's a good thing. They're gonna make sure that the keyboard works. And I have no idea if the battery is charging or not charging. It doesn't show me anything. It just, that thing keeps blinking, that thing keeps blinking right here. I don't know what all that means. It just blinks. All right. Oh, wow. We are in business right there. You see? Plugged in. That means it's plugged in. I like the screen. It's a matte screen. Really good matte screen. Let's see if the wireless picks up. All right, the wireless does pick up, and the keyboard responds to the pin input. And yeah, we are in business. I will just let it charge for half an hour, and hopefully it's gonna be working fine. Again, I'm not sure why this whole thing is blinking. Maybe the battery is not responding. Yeah. Again, thank you. That's how we do it here. The IdeaPad 3 has a privacy shutter on webcam, Dolby Audio, stylish design. All right, and a jack like that, so that every 6 months you just send a laptop like that away. I like this laptop. I hope it's gonna bring more business to me. And yeah, thanks so much, guys. Have a good day.